you're going to favor the team who's won a big LAN and gotten top three in another big LAN, or at least fairly big. I don't know.
Yeah, the first one was six teams. I don't know how big of a LAN.
Really?
Yeah.
Didn't have six. Okay. That's true. It wasn't the strongest competition.
Right. That's why people say,
hey, our last Dota Summit 10 had six teams.
That's right.
Okay. Are you trying to imply that wasn't the strongest
All I'm saying is that if you want to say that Liquid got top four at a tournament.
You want to come back to a BTS pro?
I love small tournaments. The smaller, the cozier, the more intimate it is. Yeah. You really get to know everyone. Yeah, but I do think that this is going to be the most... I mean, obviously, it's the first major, so we're going to be able to finally separate who is maybe Tier 1?
Yeah, because we haven't...
Because are any of these teams Tier 1? Are you confident saying any Tier 1
I feel like
teams?
No matter who wins this event, they're still probably not going to get the respect they deserve, unless it's like one of the big names from last season, like EG or VG.
EG, VG winning, everyone's like, yeah, you know, they're the Tier 1 teams.
Or TNC, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But these other teams are just going to be like, oh, you know, the best teams weren't there, which kind of sucks for them because it's going to...
I think it's actually good because having that chip on your shoulder not being respected normally keeps you, like, focused and motivated. Yeah, well, it's like, yeah, we're so great, you know, we're the best team in the world. We just won TI. Like, sometimes you get a little lazy, you know, it takes you most of the season to get back in fighting shape. Mm-hmm. So keep them hungry. Keep them feeling hated, like the world's against them, and you'll have a champion.
TI may have proved that trend to be incorrect, though.
Yeah, but, you know, it took the first TI where the world was against them to create that juggernaut.
That's true. So. That's the origin story right there.
No one else here has won a TI. So, into our Game 2 draft.
Yes.
Any changes you gentlemen would like to see? We see an ALK first phase ban. That was a second phase ban last time,
I believe.
So that's a small curveball. Fnatic removed the gyro.
ALK was first stage banned, but first by stage? Fnatic instead, right?
I thought it was second stage.
Alchemist?
Maybe.
It was first three, okay. But it was Fnatic who banned it first three.
Oh, okay.
So both teams saying they want to ban Alchemist. And Alliance also saying we want to ban Chen. So the hero they want. It's kind of weird to see the other team ban those heroes in some ways. Fnatic's ban, no surprises there.
Gyro.
They add the gyro in, banning the Nico Baby Void. Now
so do you get rid of Morphling now? Because I believe that was what their other first phase in the ban. Yeah. Winter Wyvern instead.
Why Wyvern?
Great question.
That is usually telling of something they
made in the pick. You want what, like a Phantom Assassin, perhaps? That's usually the first thing that I think of whenever I see a Wyvern picked as a support is... Curse is really good. Cold Embrace is really good. So, want to go for that. Technically, you could lead into a push strat because Cold Embrace, you can just Cold Embrace a creep that's tanking tower aggro. But I still feel like you wouldn't go to back-to-back push strats as Alliance, especially if you've already banned out your own Chen.
Used to be one of the popular IO counters. IO's pretty dead now, though, right?
That's true.
Post TI.
Yeah.
Went from could play, you know, carry to non-existent.
Yeah.
Flew
too close to the sun.
Might be a Magnus game for Fnatic. That's the other, I think, hero that Wyvern's very good against.
Yeah.
Good against ERP, but also good against all the carries that you partner with the Magnus to give
you
power.
Because
Magnus was banned in the first game, first three. So Alliance is stumped by it, because they're using up all this reserve time on a first three ban, which doesn't usually happen.
What if there's no deeper meaning and they're just like, yeah, just pick a support and ban it?
That's the next level.
Throwaway
ban. Out the Magnus, okay.
Yeah. So, no Magnus. There's the Morphling combos, the Morphling Shaker being the obvious one. Mm-hmm. Or there's some of the other more standard meta heroes, which are always good too. If they want to just get like your...
Right away.
I mean, Nico Baby plays... I mean, they banned out the Morphling themselves, so they're kind of leaving it on the table for Nico Baby.
Quick Undying Grab. And
Drow Ranger.
So they say, sure, go for your super crit.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll go for more push.
We've seen a few teams... This was kind of the Dota Summit trend a little bit, where teams started looking at Drow as one of the better carries against Morphling.
Yeah, pseudo-counter, I think you'd call it.
Again, this idea that you've got enough damage with marksmanship that you can bypass all of his armor, and you just outrange him, which, you know, Morphling can kind of get on top with the waveform.
Until he gets the Aghanim Scepter with the Shaker,
then
you're not outranging anyone.
So, I think Drow's actually, like, when we talk about this patch and people, we want a new patch, this, you know, everyone's picking the same stuff. Drow has been, like, one of the recent trends.
Yeah, she's having a renaissance right now.
And that's always the case. Even when there's no patches, it feels like there's this very... you know, cyclical phases with Dota where a hero will go out and then suddenly come back in without even being touched balance-wise. It's just something like, wait, Drow's actually really good against what people are picking now. And then people will find the stuff to counter Drow and Drow will disappear again.
Right.
Without a single balance change.
So you're saying we should never have a patch because there's always innovation.
Let's freeze
Dota in the time locker, you know, just like
Dota
Super
1,
Smash Brothers Melee.
Dota 1's a time
capsule right
now.
StarCraft Brood War.
I think they're stuck in like 6.83 on Dota 1 still.
Okay. Yeah, there were certain mechanics, I think, with some of the new heroes that were hard to implement, and he
like
kind of said, I think he even wrote like a final blog saying he wouldn't be updated.
Okay.
The frog.
So that one's frozen.
I want to say he did. Maybe I'm wrong. But in any case, OD getting banned, one of the better anti-morphling heroes.
And Templar Assassin, so want to make sure that Moon, which I think that Moon is going to be the secret to success for Fnatic. At least it looked that way in game one. I think 23 Savage still needs a little bit more competitive experience before he will be that reliable carry. So let Moon take the reins of being the primary core. Let Ice be irritating and kind of hold 23 Savage's hand.
It's a scary hero, too, with the Drow, like that fast pace, 20, 25-minute timing where TA's is here that gets blinked Esso, takes Roshan, takes towers, and suddenly it's like, well, Morph's not ready to fight. What do we do against this five-man lineup? Probably not a whole lot.
What's Fada got up his sleeves? So they banned the bat, no kidnapping, pick-off shenanigans against the Drow.
What do they want? Legion's available. That's something that, like, picking for 33 was banned last game, but we'll see. I think Fnatic just, they banned the heroes. You need to ban OD with the Morphling. It's just one of those heroes, if you're too agi focused, he's going to one-shot you from full health. Jeez, Nature's Prophet ban? What's going on?
Targeting Ice, I guess.
Yeah.
I mean, they're leaving the Abaddon on the table. It clearly was not that big of a concern, and they go for what I'm guessing is a Limp Puck, but
who knows?
The Puck saw some picks at Dota Summit as well. Mm-hmm. So he definitely feels like a lot of these teams were carefully watching the minor.
Yeah.
You know, taking what they liked.
They weren't watching for Dota. I was just watching because they know it's a great event, LD.
Like,
it's Dota Summit.
They were just there
stupid not to watch Dota Summit.
They were like, when is the content coming?
Yeah.
I got to wait until
Sunday. I got to see Grand Joker for the fifth time. Forget about all these hero picks and bans.
No, we don't need to learn from these teams.
It's a good story. Just, you know, keep on repeating enough and
you can believe it too.
Do you guys reckon IG will do well at the major?
They didn't do great in their Chinese quals, though, which is what threw me off because they had to go through the minor.
Which group are they in? They're Group D. So Beast Coast, Gambit, J-Storm? Yeah, I think they could easily win this group. I mean, Gambit looked pretty good
Gambit
at ESL,
but
I still think IG, like, it's like, can they clean up the mistakes? Because to me, they have a really high ceiling and a really low floor. Like, they're super sloppy, but they're super talented. So if they can, like, find, like, that perfect balance, you know, this is a team to me that could easily finish, like, top four, top six.
Especially seeing the kind of wacky stuff like JT Pudge that I saw towards the end.
That
was amazing.
That came from nowhere.
And Emo was pretty consistent throughout the entire tournament.
The downside is, I mean, they do have some pocket picks, but there's a lot of tape on them. Very recent tape compared to some of these other teams.
Exactly.
And you know at the minor, like, everyone's pulling out all the stops. ESL, DreamHack, like, they're ultimately, like, of course the teams want to win, but, you know, they're focused on the major. They're focused on the DPC. So Lina gets grabbed now. Is this a core Lina?
I think it's a mid, most likely, personally. It's a Moon hero. It's just a solid mid that doesn't have many bad matchups. And to me, it gives you, it fits some of the gaps. It gives you this more tempo hero with the Morphling that wants to farm a bit.
And it's possible he just likes the Lina versus Puck matchup.
True.
Honestly, I like the Lina versus almost anything
matchup.
That hero is so strong in lane.
Yeah, it's just a...
One
of the mids that you feel fine picking almost any game, and you don't have last pick, so you're not looking to counter pick the mid lane anyways. You know Alliance theoretically can put this Puck off lane, so just pick this Lina, and if they're going to try counter pick mid, well, what's the worst matchup you can get? It's not a TA. TA's banned. So
yeah, and in theory, they could always turn into a four-position Lina, which I think is still being very underrated.
Okay.
It was common, I think, maybe a Dream League, and then it kind of fell off a little bit, and then I was like, oh man, this is really good, and I started playing it in my pubs. It's so irritating to deal with. No other support can trade hits with you because your range is just bananas.
And you flash farm to catch up in the mid game. You can shove
so
waves really well.
Yeah.
I think it's just a worse Leshrac, though, is the thing. Like, it's still very good as a 4, but for me, it's like I'd probably rather a Leshrac.
Your way of pushing towers is exposing your hero and hitting it versus hiding in trees.
Right.
Slightly more single-target burst damage, but even Lesh has quite a lot of burst.
Okay. Centaur gets grabbed. Good catch here versus the Drow.
Yep.
Gonna be, I mean, they don't really have a save yet. Like, Undying, I guess. You know, but if this Drow gets caught out and she doesn't have the right items, she's dying.
I guess their solution to that last game was between Soul Rip and the heal amplification from Chen.
Well, they had the Chen, though. Right. Chen's like almost 2 heroes worth of heals.
Exactly.
And he itemized that way, right? With the flads, the pipe, the mech.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, I don't know.
She'll be a little bit more.
I'm a little worried for this Drow Ranger.
Yeah.
Like, I think she has to have a better start than last time if they're going to go for a similar strategy. Yeah. And you've got the ticking time. Like, the Morphling Shaker is just, you know, a lot easier to execute than, like, a PL strat come late game.
The reason their strategy worked as well was because of the Chen. With all the items that Chen had and the creeps.
Right.
So you can maybe make do without the creeps. I feel like you at least need that hero to build pipe, mech, Vlads, etc.
Right.
If you want to go for that.
That's not really a tiny build. It could be a support on or a core Undying, I guess, but
no. It's on a build that any of these heroes really want to go right now.
Yeah.
Undying's a fighter. Fada's always playing the Undying. That's a certainty. So Fada's going to have no items this game. It's going to kind of come from their last pick. But if Puck's mid, then they need just that 33 offlane hero. Maybe it's just going to be some utility offlane.
Other option is the offlane Puck, and then is there a mid that jumps out at you?
Not really.
No. Dealing with Morphling is just so difficult. You just have to play fast no matter what, because as was iterated time and time again, the Yasha Aghanim Scepter, that's it. Game all of a sudden changes dramatically once Morphling has those items with an Earthshaker on his team. Yep. Oh, and level 15. That's the other thing.
It sounds really dark.
How so?
I mean, you know,
there's
got
no
like 20 minutes.
That's it. After that,
off with his head. But he doesn't have a head, you know.
That's a head.
Where
does
a face?
This is a face.
He has a face.
Drew 2 dots.
But where does the head end?
It ends.
It when flows.
It ends where his neck.
There's
starts.
No
What's
neck.
The neck.
It's where the head ends. That's like saying, does he have hands? He has hands as well.
Yeah, but he has
fingers.
The
hands have a clearly defined end.
Nah, right.
Nah, the head also does. You guys
It kind of blends
he's
right into that.
He's basically a humanoid. You know, we're basically like 80% water,
he's
right?
Like, he's like a merman.
It's like he's basically.
We
like,
are all Morphling. Is that what you're
if
saying?
We didn't
I'm
have
70%
skin,
Morphling.
We would be Morphling. Yeah, exactly. And we have heads, so Morphling has heads.
So you're telling me if I build a blue scepter, then I can.
Yeah, you could turn it
blow
to me.
This building
yeah, exactly. Can you wave
jump
form
like
have...
5,000 feet in the air?
Yeah. You have I'm pretty sure he doesn't have bones in his body, though. I don't think you can wave form with bones in your body.
Just bones flying everywhere. Clean up your mess, Morphling. God damn
Morphling
it.
Morphling would not be allowed in China if that were the case.
Yes. Not Chengdu Major friendly.
Not the Chengdu Major. Yeah, so Fnatic close it out with the Jakiro, which I think Ice Ice has a history of running core Jakiro, but it's going to be him on Centaur, Moon on Lina, and DK mid?
His Highness.
Oh, I was thinking of mids that could build pipe, and this is somehow here I'm like, there's no way they pick
yeah,
DK.
But but you always have the DK thought, and then you're like, never mind.
I'm like, it's a Fada team that like Fada's not mid. They're not going to pick DK.
That's true, actually.
So pushes really well. Very tanky, good against the crit with all the armor as far as, you know, being good against Morphshaker goes.
Yeah.
Does get the Drow Aura, too.
Does get the Drow Aura.
Has
That's
a
true.
Super spammable, very long duration stun also, which can be quite annoying late game.
It's one of these heroes, like, I really like how it rounds out their draft. It's the same concern I have with the PL. It's like, is it a viable hero? Like, can you really play DK right now? This hero's kind of been, like, nerfed a bit into the ground over the past year or so and just sees less and less play.
Maybe. Is there anything with the nerfs that like really jumps out at you as like this is what killed the hero?
Well, I don't think DK's been nerfed that recently. I think it just goes back more like, I don't know. I don't even know when the last DK nerf was, but maybe it's just other heroes getting buffed and the
I think that's
changing.
More the other thing. Everyone else got really huge power spikes with their Aghanim Scepter.
Okay.
And DK did not get that huge of a spike.
Yeah.
His Aghanim Scepter I think is viable. I think I used to see no one going like double bracer radiance or something like that, and so he would just be a really big tanky, and then he would build the Aghanim Scepter after that, and he's just very irritating as the gigantic
dragon.
His
last nerf was 7.2. And ever since, everything since then has been a buff, it looks like.
Because Zags, I guess.
Yeah, so we'll see if the Ags makes them viable, or maybe with a Drow Ranger you don't need it. All you need to worry about is just pushing fast. Yeah. But they definitely can't push as fast as game one. With no Chen, that kind of goes out the window. And you still have to worry about the time bomb of Morphling Ags 15.
All right, Morph Shaker with 23 Savage in the driver's seat coming at you. Will Fnatic be able to force that game three? Remember, it is GSL-style groups. So very important to have a good showing here in these opening series. You drop this one, you're down to the lower bracket, and you've got a very difficult path to get an upper bracket slot in the main, or even get to the main event.
Got
to
deal with BO1s first.
Yeah. So Fnatic, see how they're going to lane this. Ice down towards bottom. It will be that four-position Lina that you are so fond of,
yeah.
Neil.
I think that has to be done.
So it's mid Shaker.
Oh.
I don't
never mind.
Necessarily imagine this was the plan when they picked it, but once they sold, I feel like this is they sold the DK and then they changed
so like
it
we
up.
Can get away with this basically.
Yeah.
Because Lina's good against DK.
Yeah,
right?
She can deal with it.
Lina DK's this is probably a more one sided matchup for Fnatic though than the Lina DK, would you say?
You think so?
I don't know.
At least similarly, maybe?
It depends what your end game is here, because I don't think either of the heroes can stop DK from farming.
Exactly. DK is kind of like, does he have bad matchups kind of?
So then who do you think is more useful with farm on your team? A farmed Lina or a farmed Shaker? It seems like they think a farmed Shaker will be able to do more damage. Yep. Which it's difficult to look at Shaker in this way because I'm so used to looking at him in relationship to the Morphling, which is like, it's great if your Shaker got farmed, but if Morphling still needs to get that Aghanim Scepter level 15, then who cares?
He's more of a playmaker generally than the Lina, you know, at least until like she could maybe get solo kills, but she's very vulnerable and squishy compared to the Shaker. So
yeah, but then my question is who's going to be making plays with the Shaker? Because a four-position
yeah,
Lina.
Centaur wants to far.
Right.
It's probably the Lina. So.
Yeah. So ultimately, they're going to be playing with each other regardless of their farm priority, but we'll see what... maybe it's just a mid lane thing.
It kind of does boil down to a mid laner thing. I feel like when you see that melee enemy hero, you want to be like, put me on Shaker.
Yeah,
like, I feel like
smack this bitch.
Any mid who has a Shaker mid is like, pick me this hero whenever I can play it. Because
yeah.
It's a fun hero to play
it is.
As a mid.
Yes, I would definitely agree with that.
Is 33 dead here? One more dual breath? No.
Has the an orb fairy soon. Fire. Oh,
you got both
breath. Couple more auto attacks, orbing towards the tower, and
it's fun.
He'll get out of there. So
has the salve, but it's a lot of regen used, but at the same time, jabs, it's a lot of mana used. He's out of mana, has a clarity double mango, though, so.
Oh, and 33 is running away from the experience. He's letting yeah. Handskin have all the experience.
It's like he's going to contest the Morphling. I think the key is one of your heroes contests the Morphling because he's pulled the wave behind tower, and one of you secures this wave. So basically, okay. There's four lanes right now.
Yeah.
You know, there's one lane behind the tier 1 top, one lane behind the other tier 1 top.
And so our mid lane, already four denies on the Shaker. Very hard to outlast hit this hero.
Yeah, I'm curious how Limp is gonna.
Also, with
up.
the DK with the Breathe Fire, like both of them are pretty good at denying last hits.
Right. I guess the damage reduction doesn't matter too much if you're critting really heavily, though.
That's true. So action breaking out in the top lane. Jabs is gonna go down here. So first blood secured. Split between the two Alliance heroes. Leaves Savage on an island here just for a second. They'll take that sec to chuck him back in, get a silence off, do some good damage to the Morphling, and they might be able to kill him here. No, not quite. He's low, though. There is a mango available into the avalanche. They're certainly going to force him all the way back with this. Keeps on diving. 23 Savage. Can he stay alive? Another chuck, a huge commitment, and a beautiful takedown. That is like the only time you can easily kill this hero.
Yeah. Morph's very slow.
Only level 2.
In some weird way, him dying, I think you'd almost rather die than be stuck there with no health regen.
Yeah.
So committing all those mangoes just to kill him when he can come back to the lane with his Wraith Bands.
With no experience miss because the creep wave's right there.
It's still, I mean, Alliance, either way, it's a win for them. But the I think killing him is slightly better for Fnatic in some weird way.
Yeah, I get where you're going with that.
Or at least it's very comparable.
What you're saying is you want to feed in the lane. That's the take.
Yeah, exactly.
Guys, please, feed away in your pubs. Yeah. Not if you're on our team.
You know, you think that supports are only allowed to feed tactically. No, carries can do it too.
They dive in the bottom lane now as Ice and Nico Baby dueling as well. Fada going to stand strong. They rotate in Handskin, and he'll try to punish DJ for this commitment. Nico Baby kiting him out nicely. The Lina stun only hits the Undying, so Handskin, he can keep on chasing. He's got more mangoes. Bought those before suiciding to the tower.
Oh, he
DJ
got juked.
Juking, but Handskin also right there with him. Not going to give this chase up easily. It's only level 2 Tiny, so he's going to need to wait for this Avalanche cooldown. Another stun. Keeps on chasing. Looks like DJ may just live to tell the tale. Handskin's going to give it up. And this leaves Ice by himself, but he should be fine. Or should he? Nico Baby wants to commit for this. Handskin coming in. Ice. He had plenty of time to get away, but he just did not respect their damage. He'll go down.
33 atop. Might kill Jabs.
And action all over the place. And one more right click. We'll do the trick. 33 grabs the kill.
1v2. Like, I'm like, I'm
but Morphling is now free farming.
Yeah.
23 and 11.
The Tiny going bottom feels pretty good for Fnatic because Morphling can free farm away, but I'm very surprised to see 33 getting a kill in a 1v2 lane.
Yeah, he's just playing exceptionally aggressively, and it's working out. I don't know if his efforts are better spent irritating the Morphling or picking up these kills, but again, what can you really do as a Morphling? I mean, against a Morphling. Yep. He does have Drow attack speed on the puck, but still, it's very difficult.
So the Bounty Rune dance has begun, and we're going to see Jabs trying to contest 33 here for the double bounty grab up top, and 33 jumping in for it. It will be Jabs grabbing, and now 33's got a TP out very quickly. He will make it out barely with his life, so it looks like it's going to be Fnatic grabbing 3 bounty runes in the end. So Morph and Shaker way up there in the CS charts. Are you quaking in your boots already if you're Alliance?
Nah, it's 5 minutes. You're okay. I mean, maybe
freak it out. It's over. We lost.
Right. You got a 1-game buffer.
Let's just give them more Shaker. Throw it away real quick.
Let's see.
I mean, the first team that like breaks the seal on figuring out how to beat Morphling Shaker, like everyone's looking at these games to find out if it's possible. Because if you don't have to ban both or one of the two heroes.
I mean, the Drow strats were like the first clinical trial of a new drug to try and counter
the
Morph
double
Shaker.
Blind kind of thing.
I'd say it's like efficacy is like, you know, 20-30%. You probably want it up at like 80-90 to call it a true counter.
Yeah, you sure it's not a placebo with all this Chen stuff backing it up, though? You may just think it's the Drow, but it's really all the other stuff that's going on in your head.
Yeah. But teams are continuing to experiment. Pubs, though, they're just raging and abandoning. I see Morphling. I quit game. So jump here. It's some dragon-on-dragon action. Who's the bigger, badder one? It looks like Limp is going to win that duel. Roaming of Handskin, they have been very effective with these early Tiny rotations. 5-1 the score.
And Jabs is just, like, eating all of it, not getting any help from the other person in his lane. Morphling's like, whatever, dude, you're dying. I got creeps to kill. Moon just wants to see us. So it all seems sacrificial.
At least with particularly the top lane is probably just like, well, I'm dying here, but my Morphling's getting all these creeps, so we don't really mind.
Worth.
The mid one, he was just there for a warding mission.
We're going to find Fada, though. Not sure if he makes it out. DJ pumping in the damage. Ice coming in with the hoof stomp. Follow-up, Lina stun. Chain stun for days. Kill secured. They have a lot of disable on this Fnatic side.
So how do you think they're going to skill this Jakiro up? Right now he's 1-1-1.
I think we'll see 1-3-1.
Okay. I will agree with you.
Oh, that's really boring.
I was hoping you would say Liquid Fire.
Oh, no way. Liquid Fire is your worst.
Yeah, I know.
I could see him getting a second point. Well, if you're going to get a second in Jewel Breath, you would already done it, so probably.
Yeah. Oh, straight slammed onto the puck.
Dunked. That was, okay. Invis Rune. Good combo.
The only reason I would have thought that Liquid Fire was on the table is Ice is probably going to go down here, and maybe DJ as well.
Oh, that's expensive.
Yeah.
Lina stun, can't make it out, and the Drow Ranger
grabbing
the kill.
Oh, no, Fada, the Tombstone Zombie got it. That bloodlust.
That sucks.
Yeah, so the only reason I would think that maybe you go liquid fire is that maybe Jabs wants to create pressure by pushing structures. Because ultimately, you want to make as much room for this Morphling as possible.
Second point in Jewel Breath.
This is the problem with the mid Dragon Knight, though. Is you leave him alone, you get a kill top, and you're going to pay with like half your tower's HP. Hanskin comes in with an Arcane Rune. Just a warning avalanche forcing Moon back. He does have some bottle charges, but has to wait for these damage over time abilities to wear off. He's now going to start bottling up. Alliance, though, on the hunt. They want to punish him. He's going to get back to safety. That leaves the Jakiro isolated, coming through with the Fissure to try and force Limp back, but he's still going to grab this Jabs kill. Very healthy. So, too, is Hanskin. They might go in for another round. These two causing all kinds of problems, and that just leaves Ice on an island down bottom where Nico Baby, Fada, we'll combine to kill him off again. So
Fada's the same level as Centaur. Undying's the same level as a Centaur.
Fada's just got insane experience.
Yeah.
Normally you think support's like kind of leading the XP for the carry, but with the kills they're getting, it's not like Nico Baby's underleveled either.
Yeah, and Hanskin's been showing up at that lane as well, and somehow they're all very, very well-rounded in terms of levels.
Four kills between the lane, it looks like. Nico Baby leveling up the Frost Arrows, and you've got insane kill potential and slow with this.
Yeah. This is the kind of point that I would think that maybe sending the Lina mid would be a little bit better, because a Shaker cannot get a DK Dragon Form off your tower. You don't have enough magic damage, you don't have enough range, you are just subject to the abuse. Meanwhile, Alina, high level with a Laguna Blade, if a Shaker rotates with a Fissure block, then maybe you can discourage a DK from going for that. But he didn't take the tower, so the tier one still remains on tower.
Yep. Yeah, Moon looking to secure some bounties here for the team. Grouping up with Jabs for the time being. Will they go aggressive? They will, and Limp is waiting up the hill.
Oh, baby.
So too is Ice. Three hero ice path coming out with the Fissure follow-up, but it's not a very high level, so they can easily shake it off and keep on fighting. Limp grabs the bounty rune, and they get to work here with the Dragonite rotating the Drow Ranger, and it's a quick stampede retreat for Fnatic. They'll grab a bounty rune on their way out. Both teams very durable.
Got the Tombstone.
DK immediately TP's out. He activated Dragon Form. He wants to get something with it.
Straight on to mid.
Okay. Because I was going to say that's the one loss, is if he popped Dragon Form for nothing. Gets a tier 1 tower, so honestly, that panned out great because Centaur ended up not being able to pick up that bounty rune, right? It went the way of Alliance.
God, that's dirty. No glyph available. Already a tier one down. Alliance have, just done a nice job of keeping pressure up on all these lanes, even though Morphling is free farming 85 CS already. So you got to be worried about that. But they have the gold lead for now.
Can he solo carry this game? Big question.
Whoa. You have to have an Earthshaker on your team, there are gods. This is not solo carrying.
It's like saying, can PL solo carry a game when there's a Coddle there? you know he's doing that religion.
Can the dynamic duo bottom lane? Hanskin getting caught out here. The Chainstone's coming through, but Fada revving up with the Flesh Golem going in, punching away on Ice. Toss it from the Death Knell. Will get the kill. They bring the Centaur down. They rotate in Jabs for this. This Fada Undying is causing all kinds of problems. They've got to heavily commit to bring him down. They will finally do so, but Nico Baby easily able to retreat. And this just leaves the Dragon Knight a thorn in their side, shoving in the middle lane. Now maybe looking to steal some stacks here.
Another really rough game for Ice. Four deaths. Keeps going back to this bottom lane and getting bullied, really.
They've invested a lot to try and secure this lane with these wards, too.
Yeah, he's had help. That's the thing.
I guess you don't really need any top because it's not like Morphling's dying. And for now, he's abandoned the lane to go to the triangle.
Yeah, no one else is really going to be jungling this early on on Alliance. Once Drow Ranger leaves the lane, basically I think the wards are just going to be following Drow around. If she's in the lane, keep it all on this corner of the map. Once she relegates herself to the jungle, then start keeping it near her farming patterns.
33 with the Precision R starting to chip away at this top tower. They bring in the Dragon Knight, so it's going to turn from a chipping to a quick smashing. And no real counter push by Fnatic. We'll see if they look to defend.
I think this game right now, if anything, feels like it's going a bit better for Alliance.
Yeah, I'm not sold by this mid Shaker versus what could have been the mid Lina.
Morphling's free farming and the net worth is even, but it's the other cores of Fnatic who are both struggling.
Yeah.
And it feels like everyone in Alliance is having the game go the way they want it to go. Whereas for Fnatic, it's only Morphling who's having a good time.
Oh, they did see this rotation Fnatic made down bottom. DJ lurking in the trees. There is a Radiant Ops.
And now you have to recruit your Morphling to help you? And you're supposed to be helping the Morphling.
Let's see if he can keep a CS up. They are going to find Hanskin in the trees, but he gets healed up, still blasted back down. They lose DJ in a hail of nukes, and now on the run. 23 Savage going to try to hoof it out of there. He should be fine.
Wait, Morphling can turn into other heroes besides Earthshaker in this game? What? Oh, wait, never mind. Oh, no. He wants to toss. Oh, okay. We have potential here.
Okay.
Only very reluctant.
Yeah, was this recently patched that turn Morph can do that?
Wait, he has an ultimate before he gets the Aghanim Scepter word? So DK form was popped. They did not successfully take that top tier one. But he's got his Maelstrom completed, so Limp is having a ball.
Not your everyday DK build.
No.
But once you had a
not your everyday DK pick either, though.
Yeah. Trying to find Moon here down at the bottom rune. He got coiled up. Reinforcements are coming in. They just got the Lina kill. Well-timed silence here, but does he have the damage or might be enough? Oh, man. Fada comes in, snags the kill with the Soul Rip, and 33 will get the last hit. Now working on Savage, but he is very tanky. Boy, they're going to bring in Limp. The stuns are there. The Drow Rancher doing work from the back lines, and Savage is not immortal, as he painfully discovers.
Dude, I don't know where Fada got all these levels, but they are paying off in spades. 4 points in the Soul Rip, this high-level tombstone, so much range for the zombies to spawn. He is making a massive difference. It should not be this difficult to kill that Undying.
Yep. Alliance are playing fantastic right now. I think their draft is solid as well, but the play this game is just, they're outplaying Fnatic.
So Dragon form is still up for a little while here. Limp wants to journey towards the top bounty rune. Maybe take a tower after that. The Hanskin will grab it. And they keep on trucking. Tower should be killable. I don't think we're going to see a Fnatic defense here.
They should be more focused on this bottom lane, but even that's a half health tower that's not been taken yet. Coil on mid.
Commitment onto Ice, Ice, Ice. The deaths just keep on racking up for the Centaur. Or maybe not. Or just a bit off the mark. Good jukes there by the Centaur, and Ice, Ice, Ice will make it out. But they did lose the Tier 1 tower while this was happening. And the map, for everyone who's not Morphling, starts to feel a little small.
All right, so Morphling's 12. Got Yasha completed, but... Oh, he wants to go for the full Manta. Possibly for the Drow silence and the Puck silence, I guess?
See, old top lane, Echo Slam, Moon dropping the Dunk Hammer, gets the kill on Hanskin. Limp just walks in, stunned to counter with the Maelstrom. He needs some help, though. His friends are arriving soon, but Moon is gone. Dragonform in 15, they've got a Catapult. Do they try to push? No, Moon, he came back in. They're going to punish this, or at least look to. With the Veil already picked up, goes for the TP out, and he is gone. Limp went the other way. So they get the Tier 1 bottom while that's happening. Fnatic, a couple of good moves there, slowing the game down.
Yeah, they need to get this Centaur blink up, I feel. Even get Lina. I guess Aetherlands is almost there, but yeah. Lina, Centaur are kind of going to become the playmakers until this Earthshaker completes his first item.
Do you think that he probably wanted to get the Vanguard finished on the Centaur first? Because he's very close to it, and then I think his team was like, dude, we need some sort of initiation. Every single fight is being started by Alliance.
Yeah, these games where you have a really rough lane as Centaur, you always feel terrible going Blink before your Vanguard, but you think, like, if I go Vanguard first, how late is that Blink going to be? It's almost like you just have to be this super squishy initiator. Well, but at least you can offer something.
They did smoke. Alliance was not scouted. Gonna show Nico Baby in mid. They're quickly scrambling towards bottom. Fada dropping a sentry.
I see Moon in the jungle too, so this could...
DJ about to get caught out here, looks like, with the Coil Veil combination. Orb by 33 off the mark, and he orbs into the stun of the Lina, but doesn't matter. With the tiny nukes coming through, grab the kill anyway.
I'm actually kind of surprised that they blew Stampede for that. It's just a Lina.
Yeah, it's, you know, a decent cooldown at this stage, too.
Yeah,
110 seconds.
But it doesn't look like Alliance are going to push bot, which is the last tier 1 remaining for Dire, so... They're just, I don't know. I guess they're making Morphling have to move around a lot, but they're not killing Morphling. Fada just straight jumps jabs.
This Twin Head is not able to take the zombie punches. And he will end up going down at his own ice and fire.
Did they got my macro down. They glyphed away.
Yeah, did they glyph just for that?
I think so. They want to be able to push off of this. They've got the DK ulti form if they want to go for mid, but they found a bigger kill.
Tier 2 top, maybe? They are in the neighborhood. Let's see where Alliance decide to strike. The blink is up on DK now. So great initiation from the squad.
So they're going to go Roche instead of the push. They left their options open. Like, they don't need that glyph because they're... Fnatic's not really applying any pressure, so if they wanted to push, they could. Instead, they're in a position where they can take a free Roshan. Alliance is looking very scary right now. All their cores getting their key items. It just doesn't feel like Fnatic have any answers coming anytime soon.
Well, they scan. They see. Can they fight, though? They don't have the Shaker Ags yet.
And Stampede is still down.
Pop the smoke with his positioning. Great play.
Oh, they're stalling them back. The Roche is getting dangerously low. Now the Coil deployed. Fnatic have to know that means it's close, but it is too late. Nico Baby has snagged it. A clean Roshan grab, and Fnatic can't punish.
Just very smart play from Fata. Position so that he can pop the smoke in the trees, then the ward scouts him. Puck knows, hey, this is like a... It was a really good timing for Fnatic to catch him in the Roshan pit. 33 knew it, so he just drops the coil to keep them out of the pit. Not even looking to fight.
And another... Stampede used to save a support.
That kind of says a lot about Fnatic's mindset right now. They are not looking to fight.
Well, backdoor protection will stay up.
Yeah.
But they still want blood. Nico Baby with this Aegis has no fear whatsoever.
Ice bottom though.
There's the silence catch from 33, but
no, he trapped
himself in the trees. Not going to matter. Nico Baby there. Clean up in aisle 3, and Alliance will get another kill. BKB coming soon on that drow, and they are ready to push.
Yeah. There was no Dream Coil, but I don't think Ice knew that. It was about 5 seconds away.
So Morphling finished off the entire Mantis style, and now working his way to the Aghanim Scepter, still a ways away, and has level 15. Hasn't skilled up either of his talents yet, though. Oh, okay, now he goes for the Morph Duration. Okay, well, you have half the combo online. But not the important part, which is the Aghanim Scepter.
They'll have the regular, you know, pedestrian Shaker Ags coming soon.
Nobody wants that. Especially if you're... Does Center have his blink yet? Yeah, he does. Okay.
Coming soon. Okay, yeah, he's got it.
All right, so at least now you have a 1-2 punch.
Blink in with the Stampede Stomp and then follow up with the Shaker Totem.
Yeah.
Kind of risky, though, against like a Puck and a DK. There's a lot of instant disables and silences to worry about.
Various.
And the Gust, for that matter.
This smoke makes no sense to me. I don't think you can achieve much. You're fighting into an Aegis. They're hoping just get a pickoff. Like, okay, Alliance will take out Tier 1, then back off, and we might be able to catch him.
Well, they did see Fada's all the way up top, not able to easily join this fight. They're going to throw everything at Nico Baby, but he just gets pushed away to freedom. Now the turnaround comes. Working on the Tiny, but the Veil of Discord does a lot of damage. Echo Slam, Moon coming in for the quick dunk, but Limp is not an easy kill. It'll be Tiny on DK action as Savage jumping up to the high ground. Can he get him even low enough? No, sirree. This Morphling is no match for the DK stun, the Drow silence, and the damage of marksmanship crushing right through him. He is far too squishy at this stage.
Just not the time to go for a fight. They're thinking, okay, we have this Ags on Shaker. Let's go smoke up. Or they only smoked two heroes for one thing, which was weird in itself. Centaur and Lina. They can't make a play, but they smoked into an Aegis.
Yeah. And they didn't even take it off Nico Baby.
I think they realized like after they jumped, like, oh, she has Aegis because they didn't throw everything on her. Like they could have committed everything and taken out the Aegis, but then they would have been team wiped. I mean, the end result is they pretty much get team wiped, but luckily they get a kill out of it because they changed their target onto Handskin.
Losing the Morph is probably as bad as losing the other four heroes, if not worse.
It seems like. You know? They have not opened this map up for Morph.
He's playing it like a normal Morph Shaker game where you just kind of feel like you're God, but there's too much chain stun and burst with the Drow Ranger and the Puck DK. Can't get away with it.
I'm also surprised why he opted for the Manta style as opposed to just getting the Axe and then a BKB, because if he goes into Shaker form, his jabs now gets picked off. He's still going to get silenced. Like, you can only purge off one of the silences, and then Puck may come in with the other one, or Drow Ranger comes in with the other one, and then you're stuck.
And this new and revitalized Alliance looking hot here. They came in with a lot of momentum, and they are keeping it up so far at Chengdu. as they're threatening the tier 2 mid, second to last outer tower remaining on the map. Looks like that should be dropping with this creep wave. I mean, at what point can Fnatic fight? Is the Ags enough to then just start taking engagements, or are you still farming your next couple items as the morph?
I hope the Ags is enough.
Yeah, but I feel that it isn't, because I think the BK, like, you're going to be stuck as Shaker and you're going to be silenced, I think.
Jumping on the bottom lane, they want to catch out Limp here. It started with the Fissure. Maybe Savage can do it. Yes, sir, he can. So Moon gets the kill. Doesn't even have to commit his Echo for that. DK, no BKB yet. He's got the gold momentarily, though, and you can see he will need it.
Smoke up promptly after, but I don't think
they want to keep this momentum going. You got to be careful.
They're going to back off.
Aegis is expiring, yeah.
Shaker and Hanskin will blink away.
Such a dangerous.
Looks like the whole squad should make it out for Alliance.
Yeah, DK without BKB is kind of what they're waiting for on the Alliance side.
Yeah, he has it. Drow already picked hers up, so they're going to have 2 10-second BKBs. Puck Ags fairly soon. Nice control tool against this lineup. I imagine Alliance will be, you know, looking to take some more fights with those.
Yeah, it just depends if they want to wait for the second Aegis. I don't think they need to. There's very little to
ice, ice, ice. Not living. Oh, those quick reactions. Maybe he is living a charmed life after all. Fissure comes through along with Alina Stun covering his path of retreat.
Oh, he got silenced. No Stampede. Or he's on cooldown.
Still
going to
go down, Blink. But at least made them work for it. The rest of the Alliance team converging. DK BKB is online. Blink stun available, but Shaker just hopping away. The big Tauren makes it back.
All right, Mole playing Ags online.
All right.
What? And there's no other items Fnatic is really waiting on.
They
at
are
this
gonna
point.
See Limp here. Ice Path coming through. No follow up. He'll secure the bounty for his team.
I think Alliance's game plan now is just play the map control game and wait for next Roshan. Like, they can just get vision, control the map, play as a team, and then, yeah, wait for get another Aegis on their Drow for next team fight. Drow is very vulnerable.
Need to be, yeah, exactly. Don't leave the DK or the Drow alone. I think that's whenever I see these Morph Shaker lineups come really online, is because you're like, oh, I have so much vision. But even with all the vision in the world,
they can still jump like four screens.
Billion mile range of Fissure, the super long range enchant. You can initiate from such a massive distance that
the Harlem Globetrotters of Dota, basically. They are playing very careful now, it seems. Limp hiding in trees. Fada out a bit more boldly and now going to blink forward, looking to catch out jabs on the Jakiro. They're going to commit the Stampede. They try to get him away. Nice Ice Path clips both. Gets him back to safety. All of Fnatic in a headlong retreat, but Nico Baby charging forward. The coil's a whiff. Everybody from Fnatic making it out. Quick reactions. Oh, maybe not Jeff. So go down, but Limp may pay with his life. He gets shredded by the crits.
The and double punch.
Come
the
on, Frost coming. And welcome to the jam.
Can Fada make it out? Oh, these ice pads are too good. BKB TP out just like that. Two arrows dead. Could have been a lot worse.
They're online. The Axe Bros.
Y'all ready for this?
Yeah. All right. Say goodbye to your towers as well. The glyph after the enchant hit. That is never feels good.
That was very entertaining to watch. Shaker and Morph just jumping in together.
There's the Arcana. They should have like a high five in the air.
Oh, man.
Fissure? Oh, he lands it on Hanskin, and he does not
know he's there.
Yeah, he doesn't.
But, that's a sad tiny.
Yeah.
No wards here, so should make it out.
So this will be the true test of if you really have the answer to Morph Shaker. Because forcing 23 Savage into the Manta style, I do think is one step in the right direction. You're slowing the timing. Like, Morph hit level probably like 16 or 17 by the time he had the Aghanim Scepter completed, whereas usually he's like level 14, just barely hitting 15. So you've added an extra variable. But this is the real part of the game. Can you beat it once he has everything available?
Shaker BKB grab from Moon.
Feels like Fnatic have a like these insta stuns that can kind of play around the BKBs. Like Limp there dies because he can't BKB until he's like already on like 10% health.
Yeah, need to like preemptively do it, I guess.
Yeah, the second that, or just have those fast fingers against the center where like he blinks on you, you BKB before the hoof stomp hits.
Yeah, I think he was hoping to just get the finish off on the Jakiro and being able to exit the fight. Yep. But then Moon jumped in, and then 23 Savage as Moon jumped in.
Alliance really want to make a move top. Shaker jumping into the wave. The insta trap is there with the quick stun from the DK. No BKB for you, sir. Frost Dragon online, straight onto the tier 2 tower. They should grab it with ease.
Yeah, it's Alliance 2 with insta stuns. The Blink DK, one of the best in the game for that.
Did Morph get the Shaker before Shaker died?
No.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
No buyback either.
Oh. This is
just
why
got the BKB.
You don't do the core Shaker, because if he dies, he's dead for a very long time.
That's, but you could say you make him a core so he stays alive, you know?
Yeah. How well does that work?
Ice. He's hiding, looking for the backstab. He's got that high ground ward, so he knows that Alliance can't get in range of him.
They
will not commit to this push.
Yeah.
They weren't. They're going for the slightly safer option. This is like a free Roshan versus a probable tier 3 tower.
Wow, are they going to go
is
for
it a
this
free Roshan?
Without the Shaker?
Ooh, Dragon Slayer mid may have revealed Fnatic's coming.
I don't know.
Looping all the way around.
This is a ballsy Rosh.
They're going to go quick.
Ballsy dive as well. Ice with the stop. The Rosh so low, but BKB popped preemptively by Nico Baby. Aegis hits the deck. He grabs it right away, killing off the Centaur. Cheese. Not sure who grabbed it in the chaos, but Morphling now on the run. Hanskin gonna get finished off there. He stands his ground. He wants to come back in with Moon. Echo Slam. Oh, it's dodged completely.
Oh, this too.
Like, doesn't matter. They've got the Enchant Totems. They still get the three kills. 33 will bait out the Echo Slam, make it back, but no matter. Oh. I mean, they have an Aegis on Drow, I guess.
That was such
a
ballsy play.
Yeah,
and
I can't believe they went for that.
I can't either. I'm like, free Rosh, you know? That's why they're making the it felt like the safe play for Alliance to make, and Fnatic were just willing to take a really, really gutsy call.
So Morphling BKB'd, I don't know what happened in the Axe Dream Coil. I don't know who it caught.
Morphling was in it.
Okay, and he was just fighting inside of it?
He was just standing there. Just holding his own. I think maybe Morph's some strength, but he was just tanky. BKB on there wasn't that much damage. And because Drow was in the pit fairly low, it's like the Drow wasn't a big threat. DK died in the pit, so.
Right.
You know, as rough of a game as Ice had, you know, still coming through big with the initiation.
For sure.
Drow BKBs gets the Aegis, but has to use it very early in the fight. Then she's pretty much forced to TP away. And, it was 33 got the cheese.
Okay.
So they do get full Aegis cheese and Rosh kill. So probably about an even trade, all things considered, but not a clean win like it could have been.
Especially seeing as how Morphling didn't even start the fight as Shaker. So all of that damage was done just a normal Morphling. Apparently it's a viable hero, they tell me, without having a Shaker on your team.
Yeah. Definitely momentum feels in Fnatic's favor, though, after that one. Even if the trade with Drow and Puck having the Aegis cheese.
Yeah, because someone's going to have to buy back for this. Enchant Totem on your tower is, I think they can threaten high ground.
Yeah. Possible bounty runes as well. Fnatic with the big edge may find themselves grabbing most of them. Unless Alliance want to risk Drow Ranger getting the top one.
Yeah, 33 is already too far back. Otherwise, I'd say Puck may go for it, but it's 5 seconds until they spawn. So a lot of people were proposing ways to nerf this strategy. I think the simplest thing is just don't make the Morphling Aghanims upgrade abilities. You can still morph as allies, just don't make it upgrade any basic abilities that can be upgraded.
So no Ags, like the Ags upgrade of the components, you mean? Or
yeah. So none of the basic spells, because you already don't get the ultimate. So then also don't let it upgrade basic spells. That would be, I think, the most gentle way to nerf it.
What are the other basic spells I could upgrade?
Not many. So there are a few weird interactions. Like you can, if your Zeus has an Aghanim Scepter and you morph as Zeus, then you can Nimbus even without having, I guess you do need the Aghanim Scepter to morph as an ally Zeus, but if it's an enemy Zeus, you can get the Nimbus. So that's one thing. But other basic spells, let's see.
There's definitely got to be a few of them.
Yeah. Oh, Decay, I guess. Undying Decay.
Yep.
So you wouldn't get upgraded. But no one runs Morphling Undying. They only run Morphling Shaker.
And why not when you can take towers like this?
Yep.
Morphling Undying used to be the thing, you know, the double
tombstone. Yeah, double tombstone.
Yeah.
It's really good. And it would still be really good.
So they'll get the tier one top. They're not going to threaten high ground, though. So playing it a little safe, not knowing if buybacks might come out.
Yeah.
End of the day, Alliance still have an Aegis on the cheese for their next fight. So that feels like it'll be a critical juncture. Can they take a decisive team fight? Can they take a tier three, start work taking down some shrines? Or will they walk right into the Morphling ES meat grinder?
Yeah, vision becomes paramount at this stage of the game, mainly for Alliance. Fnatic, if they see someone, just toss out a Fissure, and then if no BKB gets activated, then just pile on them. But for Alliance, they need to know where this Morphling is at all times.
And Fnatic always have that semi-reset with the Stampede.
Right.
Unless you have an amazing Dream Coil, everyone can just back away.
And now Shaker has his Fissure range talent, so both him and the Morphling can stun from miles away.
Yeah. That's scary. We've seen how squishy this DK can look. If he doesn't get his BKB on,
oh, Nico, baby, coming in mid. Fissure's going to cut him off. Quick hop away.
If that was any other hero, they may have committed, but the Aegis means
no dice.
Yeah.
But this vision has been great. Like, they see all these Alliance movements through the jungle.
Yeah.
They can just farm the other side, or they can smoke and make a play, and that is the plan. Moon coming in, looking for the Fissure initiation. He's going to find it on the puck. Into
oh
an Enchantona. Into the Bash Pro crit combination with the Echo Slam. Easy pickoffs. Hopping back the other way. 23 Savage. Not going to find anything more. They did force a puck buyback, though.
Hanskin may be in trouble, too. He's being chased.
There's no running from this combo. There's only juking. And Fissure, number one.
They're going
to find him. Fissure, number two, also going to find him.
They still don't know
They're
where he is,
though. They're blind, baby.
Oh, he
he's
going to
TP out.
Looks to me like Shaker needs a buff. Can we get vision on Fissure, please?
Yeah.
Call it the Fissure.
Aye. Now we're talking.
Well, right. Alliance's lead has disappeared. They had like an 8K gold lead. It's now about even. Right as soon as they got that Fissure range talent, it immediately nets them a kill on a traditionally impossible to kill hero. Puck.
But it is vision, you know, as you mentioned.
Yeah.
Like, I don't think they go for that smoke
without
that those
placed in their own
jungle.
Yeah, vision. Exactly.
They're going to try to find more here. Ice. It's on to Nico, baby. No catches BKB. Him out with the Fissure follow-up. He does have Aegis and BKB. Can they kill him twice? Will they try? They're thinking about it. Sticking around with the Macro Pyre. He's going to BKB, and Fnatic seems satisfied with that. Might just jump away. Nope, they're hopping on in. Moon catching the stragglers. Looking for Hanskin. Fissure not going to connect. The other Fissure will. Alliance won't be pursued any further, but look how easily they could just snipe an Aegis.
And a BKB charge, so...
That too.
Things are getting difficult. As well as I thought that they had things in the early game. It just... I don't know what your solution is against this strategy.
I love the impact the DK pick had early, but I'm wondering what his place is now.
Yeah.
You know, as far as, like, testing whether Morph Shaker is beatable, I feel like, you know... The Drow idea, this does, to me doesn't say Drow ideas doesn't work. It's more like this DK feels a bit underwhelming as a hero.
So they picked it last. They may have picked it against a Lina matchup, which I don't really think you do that against a Lina matchup.
High armor is kind of nice against the crits, but it's just so much damage. It just doesn't really matter.
And you had thought, Gods, that DK might be a pick. What were you hoping they would pick a DK for, though?
For the like more utility aspect,
so
I think he has
auras
the blink.
Or
I was thinking
initiation?
Mid that could be like fill in the
push
role of the Chen from last game.
Okay.
Like I was like, okay, if they want to have a similar Drow strat to last game, who is that mid that gives this like tanky push?
Okay,
and DK came to mind. I didn't say it because I'm like, no, it's DK. That sounds like a bad hero.
And you might be right as we watch this game pan out.
Yeah,
is DK bad or is Morph Shaker just good?
A little bit
say
column
all
A,
of the
a little
above.
Bit column
yeah.
B, you know? It's one of those heroes that it's like an okay hero all around. It just doesn't excel in any area. You never feel excited about it. I mean, you never, even in the past when DK was a good hero, you wouldn't feel excited about it, but
yeah,
you knew what he could bring to the
DK
table.
DK is not meant to be like that sexy, you know, one night fling. This is like a stable, old, reliable, long term relationship, you know, style hero. But
everyone's been cheating on
him. It seems like everyone's cheating on him. He's headed straight for a divorce at the rate things are going. Limp is
why hasn't Dragon
wearing
Blood
out his welcome.
Why hasn't the Dragonblood passive been reworked yet? All these passives have been slowly phased out and made more sexy, but Dragonblood is still just boring-ass HP regen and armor.
Activatable aura for the whole team. That would be great.
I mean, that was... Ice Path catch out, too,
with the Veil and the Fissure combo. You ain't going anywhere, son. Quick cleanup. Boom. And now the chase forward, 23 Savage.
He went backwards.
Be careful.
Get in there.
Yeah.
Come on.
Who cares about your
no
BK
confidence.
Out?
Respecting the buybacks, I suppose.
You don't respect when you pick Morphling or Shaker. That's the most disrespect possible.
You pretend to respect for, like, 20 minutes.
Oh, you're beating me. You're pushing all my towers.
Oh, I feel so helpless.
What do I do?
Michelle farm.
I think that might have been the death of DK was when the Dragonblood talent moved from 20 to 25.
Yes, that's true.
That was the nerf that killed the hero.
I mean, well, he used to have the 40 strength.
Exactly.
40 strength at 25.
Yeah, so they nerfed the strength and moved it to level 20, I think.
Double Dragonblood at level 20. Yeah, exactly. You get 25 strength at 20 now.
Although his GPM talent used to be lower. I think
it used
to
be 180.
I thought it was 150.
Might have been.
But yeah, 210 is bananas.
But you would never get the GPM talent because the double Dragon Blood was so good.
Oh my god.
That's a, you know.
No words are required, only sound effects.
There's two heroes that can use Fissure, and that's like one of those spells which you just hate to play against as Puck.
Well, really is anyone. It's
Especially
when there's two of them.
Got this Aeon disc thinking it could save him, but even that only works every couple of minutes.
Did he disassemble it just then?
They proc'd before.
Yeah.
Earlier.
Yeah,
I'm
that's
not
what
sure.
I thought.
Yeah, I think they proc'd it somehow.
Okay.
Well, Nico Baby trying for the hiding
oh,
in the tree. Oh, not again. Come on, man.
He didn't even mean to be there.
Yeah, he blinked
in. You blink in, and well, there's probably a fissure and all kinds of damage waiting for you. Quick, easy kill. And now onto the tower for 23 Savage as he agimorphs and we'll be bringing it down in short order. It looks like Glyph comes out. They did buy back. Dragonite has his ultimate, but they're still down a Puck for 40. And Fnatic, just like that, going to take Arax here, it appears. Just working through it with Moon and Savage. Drow illusion. Only a Pest, not a Pestilence. And yeah, there's the melee down. Fnatic will get out with ease. It just doesn't seem like Alliance have any ability to punish them at this point.
That's such an incorrect statement.
Dude, that's why getting level 25 on Morphling is the most valuable level 25, because you get every hero's level 25.
That is some comedy gold there.
They ended up backing off because I think 23 Savage is out of mana, so they were like, the game's over anyway.
Alliance looking to rewrite that and smoke up, but...
Feels pretty desperate.
A few more seconds until Roche. Well,
I don't know if you want to get caught in the Roshan pit anyways.
There's maybe a centaur eggs right now.
If all the fissures stack up, you'll get bounced out of the Roche pit.
So you got to worry about the 40% damage reduction. As though it wasn't already hard enough to get a kill for Alliance.
Yeah. They scan. Roche hits red, but... then goes green, so no one's in there now.
And they can just wait. They already got the top melee rack, so that lane's going to be constantly pushing. They take the shrine as well on the way out, so that means that if someone wants to slow down that push, they're going to have to at least be somewhat out of position.
Yeah, it feels like...
And you see a hero top, you can, like, instantly close the gap on anybody.
Just toss out a fissure near their ancient. You're probably hit someone.
And speaking of tossing out fissures and hitting someone, they found Hanskin.
It's like, bruh.
Fissure, or Ice Path, rather, coming through. I see long line, I think Fissure. They've got a Ghetto Fissure. So Fnatic will keep on shoving in this middle wave, Tomp Lane doing its work for them, and just dance around the pit. They'll send jabs in as the bait. Oh yeah, you want this, Shakiro, don't you, buddy? Backup could be coming in, though, with the fissure, with the dunk slamming forward. But Pug able to just phase shift and orb away. Limp standing strong through this. He's very tanky. They didn't focus down the draw ranger early. That's going to force 23 Savage back, but BKBs are ending. There is a cheese on Limp. Oh, the lockdown's there on Moon. They're going to get the kill. And 23 Savage has to hop out of there. Ice getting chucked in from ultra long distance. Do they have the follow-up, though? He's also tanky. Dust coming through, jumping back forward. Morphling commits, but the phase shift, the kiting. It's the Drow Ranger punishing this Morph. They will kill him off. The hubris on the water, man. He's got buyback. Might need to use it, but they're going to be down a Shaker, down a Centaur. Alliance, there's the counter bait on the Jakiro initiation.
Well, last time they were able to fight in the pit without the Shaker, but I think the game has changed from that point.
What's Jabs thinking there? Just walking in and feeding. That's the kind of play you make it 15 minutes in the game when you're like a 5 trying to get some wards down. But at 40 minutes in the game, in a Roche standoff, you don't feed.
I think it was a call.
It was a call. Like, send them in, and then as soon as they go on you, we're just going to blow them up.
Yeah, because so I think the idea was with the Centaur damage reduction, we could theoretically buy enough time that they have to spend so much time killing this Jakiro, and then get way back.
You're using Stampede damage reduction on your 5 position. That makes zero sense to me.
Well, the other thing is the Morphling committed on Puck, and then Puck just phase shifted, backed away.
You
want to get those like quick assassinations, and they just couldn't. The Drow silences were huge, twice on the Morphling, forcing him back. But Alliance continue to impress in this late-game decision-making and kind of, like, scrappy play. And Fnatic kind of sloppy looking, and here comes the punish.
That should be, like, Centaur. Centaur's got 3.7k health. Send him in to do that, maybe.
He doesn't have a way to take off the silence, though. So he needs to stampede. That was their idea. It's like, all right, we stampede, we get out. But I guess maybe part of the problem was that it was that the worst possible timing for Fnatic. It was like right as Jakiro was clearing the stairs but did not get up the stairs, so they didn't have high ground vision.
Yeah.
They just saw him being disabled. It was like,
throw Fissure, go.
Yeah, exactly.
Everybody go.
And so Morphling jumps in, ends up finding the Puck instead of a target that he actually wanted because he was just YOLOing his way in. And it just was a...
But, man, that hurts. All of a sudden, down a Rax mid, you had the... just passive advantage with that top lane pushing in. No longer the case. Now an Aegis on the Drow. She's starting to really pack a punch and is going for a Hex, it looks like.
23 Savage, does he smell a DD rune? No, not yet.
What do they smell like?
Smell like burnt victory. Smell like napalm in the morning.
So, Hex on Drow, huh?
With cooldown reduction.
Oh, hell yeah.
25 cooldown reduction playing against Morphling. These BKBs on Dire are going to be
seems
mostly
like
5 seconds.
Seems like a great pickup.
Yeah, I'm really into this. It makes a lot of sense.
There is a single Lotus Orb on the Shaker, I guess.
Oh, Lina gets a Scythe also. Okay.
But no Lincolns.
No Lincolns.
We are in a similar situation where Alliance can just shred buildings
like
they did last game. So could potentially see and a huge commitment here for the throne if somebody gets caught out without buyback.
They have to be... very careful. They can't, even with an Aegis, like...
Speaking of care, Fnatic are smoking, coming from behind. They walk right into Limp, who gets up the BKB. He's going to lock down Ice. They bail him up. They start pushing him around with Frost Arrows. The Fissure is enough.
Oh,
he gets
detection.
Glimmered away. No detection. And while that's happening, Hanskin assassinated on the side by 23 Savage. And now limping forward
the
underneath. Oh, baby, hexed up. Can they lock him down?
Ice.
Oh, they burst him once. Now they should be able to get him a second time with the Echo Slayer coming through. Limp so low. Finished off as well. No buyback on him. Nico baby, can he do it with the zombie apocalypse? Him and the Puck against the world. Not looking great for him. A quick adaptive strike waveform and dunzo. Doesn't even get DJ. Just like that, a team wipe.
Oh my god.
That could have been so bad for Fnatic initially. Like Ice almost gets blown up, but the Glimmer Cape saves his life, and then he comes back and hits a three-man
stop. The Tiny was the one with Dust, and he was on the other side of the fight.
He was getting finished off by the Morph.
There was a gem that Alliance claimed as well. I guess they just weren't carrying it, maybe?
The Obs died that was on, like, the Dire Obs died that was on their Shrine area. That won them the fight, because 23 Savage was able to just directly pound onto the Drow Ranger, and so... who refreshed? Was it the Puck refreshed?
The Puck had the refresher shards, yeah.
And again, they're getting the Dream Coils off, but no one, they're not splitting the fight. They get the Dream Coil and Morphling's like, alright, cool, I was gonna fight here anyway, dude.
Man, that four position Lina, you know, most other supports they would not have this many items
no,
at this stage
definitely
in the game.
Not.
But The Hex there was really game-changing as well by DJ.
Yeah.
Suddenly they're pushing down mid. Morph up in Alliance's business and sieging this tower rather rapidly with the double damage rune.
Oh, wait. Wait, did he get another one?
Oh, dearie me.
It's 40 minutes, you know. Chance, you get one at least every...
Every, like, two bounty rune spawns. Or two rune spawns.
So they're not supposed to be back-to-back during single spawns, but I guess they can be back-to-back whenever it's double spawns?
They can be in the other location, I believe. I think it's just the same location, kind of the same rune twice
I mean, there are enough runes that you don't have to double up any of them back-to-back.
Yeah.
But what do I know? And they get, what, all four bounty runes? Two buybacks cashed out? Not good.
Yeah. Drow... Scythe sounds great, still a ways off here. Doesn't really seem like there's any other big pickups on the horizon. They got the AC for the DK last fight, but we saw armor only does so much against this crit combo. So Fnatic will now back off. Farm a bit longer. You gotta wonder how much pressure Alliance are feeling. Do they just sit back and farm? Do they try to make a move again? The map is very dark for them.
Yeah, whatever happened to the gem. It's going to be hard. What was the gem situation?
There is an Alliance gem in the Fnatic base earlier, on the Curia. So it looks like it's been passed to Jakiro.
Okay.
Because that was originally Fada's
gem. Okay. Yeah.
Although Fnatic had it the previous Roshan fight, so I guess it's been passed around a bit.
And Alliance have no gems? Alliance have no gems.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah. Just the one gem both teams are sharing. I think Alliance had the gem last fight but lost it, though.
Yeah. That's what I'm guessing would kill the...
33, jumping in on the Morph lane. A quick response with the BKB and the Shaker looking to turn this around. They are going to catch him. However, coming in a bit too far is that Centaur. Very tanky, though, with the help of the Stampede. He gets away up to the high ground. The Glimmer Cape going to save him, retreating out successfully. And Alliance just walking back.
They just ran over their own fissures. They pop them out. Centaur stampedes. They all walk over it. And they disengage.
Oh, Jabs is still pretty low here, though. But Ice coming back in. Looking for the Fada kill. No, it's actually Nico Baby caught in the crossfire of the fissures. No buyback out for 2 minutes.
Laguna.
And now it's Morphin time. Mighty and quickly bringing down every Alliance here on the map. Three heroes dead. Three heroes with no buyback. That's the GG. Just like that, your life flashes before your eyes. Morphling gets an ultra kill, and the Grim Reaper cometh. Alliance tied up 1-1 now with Fnatic.
Whew. Good old Morph Shaker.
Good old.
Good old.
We're hoping it's old. It is good, though.
I was entertained. You know, it's beatable.
As far as OP combos go, at least it's an aggressive one.
Yes.
You know?
Oh, for sure. I would take this over any sort of, like, Naga combination or something like that. Yeah, no, this is it's entertaining, but I don't know.
It's hard
really,
to play against.
Yeah, I don't know what you could do better than Alliance did during the first 20 minutes of that game. They took quite a few structures. They did not lane heavily.